Welcome back, ladies and gents, to Face the TV, here where we are finally ready to conclude this best of three between Denial and their opponents. TST. I'd lost it there. It's been a while.
I just wanted to watch you rise. You say you conclude, but it's only 1-0. Could go all the way here.
Okay. Let's do this, guys. Let's jump into the match. We've got ourselves some cash on hand, I do believe. We just had a 16-14 result. I say we just had about an hour and a half ago, a 16-14 result. There we go. A 16-14 result on Dust 2. Denial actually taking, I think...
It's 8-0, DDK.
What are you doing to me, James? You are a devil. You thrive on my misery.
Yes, I had to get some cheap thrills in there because, yes, it has been a long evening indeed.
I've been in this chair for 14 hours. It's been good. At least the chair is fairly comfortable. I wouldn't say that it's very comfortable, but fairly comfortable.
I think you're going a bit too deep into the...
It's an appropriate description, James. I'm always about removing ambiguity from everything. I think ambiguity is annoying.
I think sometimes it doesn't matter.
Well, okay, James. You're entitled to your opinion. I'm going to go with that one.
So, they are due to start the knife shortly. And, I mean, from what you've seen,
right?
Do you have an idea? Like, do you have a favorite for this map? I mean, we've seen Denial a number of times, but it's fairly new for us to see TST here.
Yeah, I mean... I should think that Denial will have the edge here. I mean, it's a team that has had a lot more time together recently from what I have seen, and also a team that should have more routine because of it. And this is a map where I should also think by the same token that they should have a better grip of the metagame and also how to play some of the CT setups. And the nerf round obviously is going to be very important as both teams are going to be vying to begin their life on cash on the CT side to get that that edge that you inherently have as a CT on this map. And it'd be interesting to see what TST has to bring to the table. Again, a team that we don't really get to see, and although we do see Denial from time to time, it's always good to see more of them, as we are going to see the knife rounds conclude pretty poorly for Denial. And if TST pick the T side, then I'll be very surprised. It just should not happen. So they're going to switch. There we go. So they do go for the switch, and the Denial are going to be ready on the T side here, as well as we're going to have the stream team. I do like that name, the stream team. It's cool. So it's not quite the A team, but it's almost there.
So you can see what our delays were about, guys. So you can see some masks in the game.
It was worth the hour wait.
Absolutely, it was. Anyway, thanks, Valve.
Thanks, Valve.
All right, we're going to be in a pistol round. TST on the CT side, the heavily favored CT side. How heavily remains to be seen, but fairly heavily.
So.
Oh, wow.
Maybe an advantage for Volcanic, considering he made this map.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, 16-0 TST.
He's the architect, man.
16-0.
Check it out.
Rumor has it, he has a secret door.
Did you just see
which
that?
Goes onto the roof of
that
the
Matrix reference? You're going to ignore that? Okay,
yes,
fine.
Sir.
Fine, screw you. All right, they're going to make their way in, though. And let's see if they're able to bring about a victorious push onto this side. Opening it up with a jump shot. Style points are going to be attributed to Nash. As the bomb just barely goes down, I'm unable to stop that. And they're not actually doing a good job here, but Statutory Ape is ready to set things all awry for his opponents as he does take down Shazam over in A main. Naf, though, taking no prisoners over in the back of the site, wreaking havoc as that bomb is ticking away. Not to find another head, though, as Daps has left the man alone here and actually has a kid as well. So Statutory Ape is going to be able to bring about the defuse, but that was a very bloody pistol round.
Indeed. And I'm wondering how these masks work. Do they appear after the match, or do they appear during the match? It's kind of difficult to see at the moment. Maybe they appear on dead bodies, I'm told. So at least that's something. Okay. So let's see how this pistol round two is done here for Denial. It will be a rifle round, however, for TST, as we'll see the anger Famas taking down Shazam. Adrenaline following up with a frag on that flight, and looking like a good eco so far here for the CCs. No damage on the board whatsoever, in fact.
I really think that is my favorite impulse skin. The bullet rain. It's really nice. Anyway, yeah, they are gonna, the last two players are gonna kind of drizzle into the site now. Deagle trying to find itself a destination. Somebody's head, but nothing. And 2-0 then, as we all move into the following round. The bomb did go down, of course, so here is the buy for Denial. And we'll have to see what they're able to scrap together here. Not a huge amount of grenades. You know, they did invest in some pistols in the previous round, and that was the sacrifice that they made, not having grenades here. So I wonder if they have a strategy which will allow them to make use of a very, very few amount of nades.
All right, so passive play here from Denial, possibly looking to just peek over mid. Indeed, that is what they're doing. Going to go for the mid push, possibly opening the vent here. Indeed, they will, but the counter boost is coming in from the CP2. We'll find who first. Volcano trying to get sneaky there on his own map. But we'll be shut down by the CTs and have to retreat. Excuse me.
And Denial. Nice pick there from Naf onto Adren. That was gorgeous. Anger is on the angle, looking towards shot. Oh, there's the peek, actually, from Anger. Doesn't get spotted immediately, so able to back away after he gets the information. So they are trying to see what they can do to bring a rotation about, but there is a player, it was Daps over by B, kind of preventing that rotation for the B players. And now they're just down to Anger, who's by the white truck, the pickup truck. He's going to be able to get a good chunk of damage into a lot of players, but no frags found, and that's certainly going to really put a dampener on his day, as we can see that Denial are just sticking tight to the site, waiting for the push to come in. Fugly ready with the peek there, but not going to find anything as Statutory 8 makes his way around A main. The bomb is ticking, though, very quickly now, as it's soon to explode. Statutory 8 has to make a quick couple frags, as it's getting too late. Daps, though, does manage to take down one player and the defuser. Statutory 8 will fall, and that'll be the round there for Daps. Oh, he's just not able to survive. Just barely caught by the explosion before the round switches to the next one.
Right, so it is 2-1 in favor of TST at present. They are going to be forcing it up here. Anger only with a 5-7. Again, we have three players without helmets here. And Nathfly and Nitro do have galores, which means that they are basically AKs if they do engage with those particular enemies. It will be one shot to the head and dead. Anger is going to be the only person on the B bomb, sorry, on the A bomb site here versus five terrorists. This could be bad, could be good.
So in comes the push onto the A site. Well, with a good opener, a couple entries found already. Too much trouble. Oh, that's a brilliant shot there from Fugly, taking down Volcano as Adren comes in. The bomb is planted, though. In a way, it's a 2-on-2. Naf with a significant health disadvantage. That is evened up, though, thanks to Shazam over there in A main. As Naf gets smoked off, and so does Shazam. They have to go through the smoke to try to make this work. One player spotted. The call going to go out there. As the defuse shooting to come in, Shazam does take down both. And that's a great end to the round for Denial, as Shazam makes the clutch happen. And their money is certainly very, very poor, as all these kills are coming in from TST.
Indeed they are, and it's 2-2 already, 15 headshots on the John Wick counter there, so things are getting a bit heated here. See if they continue to turn it up. So again, we've seen a lot of back and forth matches in general over the last week, and so far this is one of them as well. Just the trades coming in, trade. See what can be done by both teams. So we have four P250s on Team Volcano, Team Cash, versus the AKs and Galils of Denial. Shazam saving for the AWP there, of course.
So they are all very close to middle, actually, if we have a look at the setup. all ready to just jump, just leap and pounce upon Denal as they make their move. They do, in fact, go to test middle and dropping down. Pex going to find himself at the mercy of Naf as Fugly and Daps are ready to push themselves onto way. Of course, the stack in middle is not going to be successful, not finding a frag and just losing Pex so far. Not sure if it has been worked out that there is a stack there, but regardless, it's not going to find much effect. So we do have Shazam waiting for someone to come through from either B or middle. He's going to find himself two players. He is actually going to get taken down immediately as Nitro goes in with the Galil. Bomb down though, and just popping some heads. Only one to be popped though, as Anger does come in with the return. There is Naf with his response as well, as things look better and better for Denal in this round, and the pistols don't seem up to par.
Indeed. 3-2 to Denal now. Still early days. Very early days indeed here. Round 6 coming out now. 5 in the board. Let's have a look and see who is doing what on these teams. And that flyer with 8 kills there for the terrorist side. So he's doing great work. Almost taking out the team twice over so far already in 5 rounds. Again, we have the lack of armor completely on Adren. Mr. Ape and Pex. No helmets for them.
Going down there towards the site. That's going to be perfectly timed to cut off Adren. He's going to have to rotate. Did I cut you off there, James?
No, no, I was only going to say something. I completely forgot what. It doesn't matter. It wasn't important.
All right, well, it's going to be important for Volcano to stay alive here. He's going to need to hold on whilst the Molotovs go down. That's great. Oh, beautiful stuff. Volcano burning alive as they have obviously rehearsed this one. Factory 8 coming in from the top. Let's find the frag onto Naf. There's a Nitro and Shazam find one each. And it is a 4-on-2. And this buy from TST is certainly providing them with a lackluster result. And they are going to have to, I believe, eco after this one. If they lose it, they are broke. This would be a good sign if they were StarCraft players. They would be looking at some sick macro, everybody on $0. But yeah, this is not StarCraft, this is CS. So low money is certainly not a good sign. We're going to have Adren coming in with the AWP. Should be able to keep it alive, actually. He does hit the shot onto Daps. Adren, it's always a joy to watch him play, actually. I really, really like watching Adren executing a lot of these fights. He's got some great in-fight decision-making. And generally, just a really nice and on-point and consistent aim. He's a good man to entrust with the AWP, as he is with a rifle. But so far, he's not going to be able to make much of a difference, as Denal were able to effectively isolate him behind smokes and keep themselves ahead of the game.
Indeed. Now, let's have a look at the approach for both teams here at the early stages of the round. It is a buy for both players, both teams, sorry. I've got orbs on both sides. Narrowly surviving is Shazam there after he gets picked against from Adren, but Adren just about missing the shot there, going for the timing pick, just misses again. If only he knew. Does finally find a frag on Nitro. Volcano bringing down Fugly, and left by bringing down Volcano in a trade frag.
And two players from Denal left on the site. It is certainly looking quite shaky for them. Statutory 8 with some fantastic kills and a great pop flash that was able to give him another frag on the entry when there's just 3 of them left, but now it's all on Naf. And Naf is looking at every corner, finds a single player. There's one up top though. Still, Statutory Ape is bringing down a lot of pain with that M4 from above, as he does get himself a triple kill in that round. Very well played from him indeed, as we are going to see TST back in the match with the AWP onto Adren, and it's a very even money situation, it looks like.
Well, we have Denal with 2 players lacking primary rifles here, so maybe a bit lopsided towards TST, in fact, as they also do have an AWP in addition to 4 M4s. Got a nade coming in for the boost spot there, but most of these players are going to be heading towards a main for the time being. Just 1 or 2 players just loitering, looking for the flank. And the rest of them are setting up 4 grenades now, just waiting for that one in A main to dissipate. And we may start seeing the nades getting chucked in soon. Indeed, here we go. There's a smoke which is going to completely nullify Pex's position here. They can't see anything right now.
and they go to the back of the site. Pex with a good defense so far. Naf gonna go down. Fugly gonna go down, but in comes Daps and Nitro with two in kind as they manage to try to get this site under control. The bomb planted in the smoke. Big result there for Denial as Nitro falls back towards Squeaky. So certainly not the easiest place to run a defense from. Gonna escape that position as he does find ahead of Pex. Moving forwards now with the two remaining players, Volcano and Statutory Ape left. Oh, he knows exactly where to place his crosshair through that smoke to find the diffuser. Brilliant stuff there from Nitro so far. One more player to be found, trying to look for the traitors. In goes Statutory Ape, does take the kill, but oh, the bomb is so far ticked. That's going to be the round there for Denial.
Tries to save the AWP, not going to happen. That is going to be everyone dead from both teams. So it's going to be expensive for all here. And looking at the money, this is going to be not ideal for either side. But it looks like Denial will manage to get out a full buy here in terms of weaponry. But the nades may be lacking indeed. We do have the CZ and the Deagle coming out. Deagle on a Dren. It's going to be interesting to see if he can pop any heads with that. And a P254 Volcano. So TST fighting themselves, ecoing on the defending side here. But can they defend? That is the question.
The interesting thing is that they have very, very, very low amounts of nades, and they've decided that the best approach for this will be this B-bomb site. So in they go, and they do, of course, get themselves in with the use of minimal grenades. They do actually have someone waiting for the flank. It's going to be Nitro, who is going to find himself both kills, in fact. Tech's going to fall there as well, so beautifully executed around. They even hold on to most of their grenades, not really having to use any of them, so that's going to save them some money here and there. But generally speaking, Denial are looking really good at the moment. Six rounds already. This is breezing on by.
Indeed, it is starting off fast here. And AWP is coming out once again for Adren. No helmets whatsoever on the CT side. And once again, it won't matter a single bit as there are all AKs and AWPs on the team side. So CT saving themselves a little bit of money there. And that money they save could mean the difference between winning or losing later on in this match. Now, we have the T setting up for A once again. Anger's going to shoot Nephi through the door after he gets pretty much sprayed down there. So that's going to be a one prong less to assault this part of the map. Shazam looking for an opening pick at the AWP, which may be the catalyst to start his team running into the site with the nades. But they've waited long enough, and here they come.
Yeah, in they go, already a man down. Gonna have to come out with a big result. That's two men down. Tex will get found, but he is gonna take Daps down to 10 HP as a Nitro does get the save onto Daps to allow him to plant by taking down Anger. In comes Volcano back. Oh, the double for the FAMAS. Beautiful stuff found by Volcano. The architect is gonna find himself another one with the help of Statutory Ape. And he is even gonna get defused to top it all off. A neat little bow to type the package, and great round, great defense from TST, already thinning out the attack before it actually hit, so that seemed to be the difference.
Indeed, but that double kill at the back of the plant area, well, back of the site, not plant area, also known as quad, I believe, was crucial here into keeping TST into this game, actually. They are trailing on the more favored side here, the CT side. And they're going to need to put a difference to that. And that's a good start there from Adrin taking up that.
Making their way undeterred towards this B split. Great shot up top found by Shazam as Nitro goes in with the AK-47. Going to be able to spray down a multitude of players as they are all succumbing to the AK-47s of Denial all over the site as Shazam finally gets the plant. It's not a safe plant though, but at this point it shouldn't matter too much. Oh, nice attack there, but Nitro will find the head of a Dren as Pex is going to drop himself through the vents. He's the last man standing for the CT side TST as he's going to pick up the first kill. Nitro going to fall. Let's see if he can find something else, but the peak from Naf is going to prove to be too strong as we have a 7-4 scoreline. Denial generally looking better at the moment, and it does seem like TST now finally unable to hold on to that money and are going to be forced to play the eco.
Shazam still continues with the AWP here, and we have full nades, full AKs here for the remainder of his team. Let's have a look at where these ecoing CTs are going. Looks like they're going to try and stack A or maybe go for an early peek in A main. No flashbangs to go for the aggressive peek there. Mathlight is approaching and is going to bounce some kind of nade off towards Pex, which is going to put him on 88 HP. So not that all that kind of massive damage. Anger going to rotate his position based on that. And they don't seem to play the CT trial again with all the power cables here.
Fugly taking down statutory ape is a good start for Denal there, especially as the push is coming in towards A, but it seems like no one's actually rotating, so the bomb can just go straight to B. And that's exactly what's happening. So much pressure still being pushed onto this A bomb site. And with, you know, of course, just with the CZs, no armor really. It's just a good situation overall for Denal. Now, they have sustained massive damage onto three players, but they've kept everybody alive, and that's the important part. No AKs on the ground and no economic damage really done thus far. Here they come, though. They do find finally the frag onto Naf, as we do have Anger in the midst, just inside the smoke. And it's two players right below him. I think he's about to get spotted. Let's see if he's able to pick up the kill. Oh, the jump CZ onto Anger from Fugly. And Adren will turn the corner, finds himself somebody hiding. And I think we just saw the mask there as he died a little bit. Oh, I wasn't really afraid though. Are the masks supposed to be scary, or what's the point of the masks?
I don't know. No, I don't like it.
What's the point of the masks?
Denial four rounds ahead now. We've got 2/3 of the elapsed rounds so far. And let's see what kind of buy we have from the CTs here. There's going to be two AKs that they've managed to salvage and three M4s versus the non-stop onslaught from the stream team. Looks like we're going to get a quick peek into A, but it could be a possible boost outside, actually. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. Indeed, it was the boost. So we'll see how this plays off. Tech is up on the boxes at the moment. So you can see his angle there, and it looks like Shazam is looking at the door. We've got wallbangs coming through. Oh, wow.
Oh, that is new. That is a new tech right there coming in from Denial. And that is very, very well done. It didn't cost him anything to do that really either. So beautiful stuff there. We're seeing the game evolve in front of our eyes as they go for the double back, catching all the players rotating. Volcano going to get absolutely cut to shreds by the AK bullets of Denial as they do make their way towards that B bomb site. Just trying to beat TST to the punch on that site, to the positions, to get the plant as Adren is going to get taken out in middle. So it's actually really nice how Denial are playing. Not only catching the initial rotation, they're going to leave players in middle as well. As Anger is going to come in, he might just find himself. Oh my god! Anger almost got them lining up for him. It's a 1-on-1 and he won't do it. Nitro takes him down in the end, and that's going to secure the round. But that was very scary for Denial. They go 9-4 though, which is actually a pretty damn great score for the T side. If you're looking at least at the European scene and the way things tend to work out there, it tends to be a bit CT sided in good old Europe.
This is absolutely a huge half here for Denial. That is without a doubt. TST on the favored side, only 4 kills at the moment, and they're going to have to change something and change something fast. They could still make it 9-6, for example, and that would be a lot better than 9-4, a lot better. But will they? That is the question. They are on the eco round, so it's looking less and less likely at the moment.
Getting absolutely mauled now by Shazam. 2 frags. Oh, Adren going to find his head in midair, and that's going to take the frag. And they do find themselves the weapons that are on the floor, but their positions are... Naf has found himself Adren. There's not just Volcano to worry about. Naf will find him as well, and he's going to pick himself up the AWP. And that's going to be a pretty well-controlled round by Denial. TST not able to find all that much at the moment, as we are seeing the Hedgehog kind of up to 38 in the John Wick Invitational. And so, look, Adren now back on the AWP. Shazam on the AWP. Are they going to collide? I don't think that's the case. It's like they are going completely different directions at the moment. Middle for Adren, and be for Shazam as they aren't messing around, are they? Straight on into the bomb site. Volcano putting in work here from CT Spawn, able to pick up another kill. That's two for him. As now we're seeing the rotation coming, but a bit of a skirmish that Daps is going to come out on top of as the denial are 3 against 3. Daps able to help his teammate out there whilst also helping to shoot him down to 8 health. Lots of there's over a minute left in the round. They could even double back if they wanted to, but they're deep into the site. So Daps over by headshot. Cause some havoc. The bomb yet to make its way onto the site. In come the grenades. So Shazam chucks over the Molotov, and that's a very nice one. It's going to get the bomb down for sure. And Nanga remaining at the moment to try to make their way back in. But Shazam on this angle, surely not to be trifled with. Going to take the first frag. Adren goes down. Anger goes down. It's 11-4 first half. That is brutal. Denial showing, I'm not sure whether it's just a little bit more experience, but really nice execution.
Now. Let's see if TST can get back into this. They are on the less favored side. The pistol is going to be their best chance for a while here to kind of start the race back into this match. Denial on 11 rounds. They are 5 rounds away from victory here. If they get this pistol and don't get eco'd on the second round, then they are going to be closer than close. But maybe a few seconds until we see an engagement here. We've got Volcano heading towards the door. Hex keeping an eye on A main, but looks like the CTs are playing for the retake as far as A is concerned. We've got Nathalie rotating between mid and A. While his teammate will just keep an eye at the back of the mid area. And we've got, again, one person playing Car as well. So, TST just looking for overextensions from these CTs, but it's not going to happen anytime soon, it seems. Fakes coming in here, Smoke coming in mid, just to deny, again, information. No pun intended. See what happens here on the pistol.
Going in now. And the pistols are blazing as they go in for the Glock train. And so far, they're getting absolutely mauled by Denial, only losing Fugly. The rest of them standing up tall, proud, and very healthy at the end of that round. 12-4, the scores. Now, TST are looking to be in a very detrimental situation. Gonna decide to pull out the CZs and the Tech-9. Tech-9 on Anger there. So not often the Tech-9 does come out to play. In fact, 2 Tech-9s, Volcano 1 rocking a Tech-9 as well. I want to see something done with these Tech-9s. To see if they can surpass the Famas buy, which is on all of the players. For the
indeed it is, and we're going to have 2 people loitering outside of the bomb site, just trying to bait one of the CTs to come out wherever they are. Those 2 Tech-9s, they could do some serious damage here. I'm not sure exactly what the range is for the one tap to kill, but it's not going to be terrible, so he's going to have to keep that range. And look at that, it's going to be Shazam down to 2 HP already. So this is what we're talking about with these guns. Very dangerous, very, very dangerous indeed. Had the recoil change up on them in a few weeks ago, which made them considerably better than they used to be, where no one ever picked them, ever. But now we can see the whole TS, well, not whole TSC, but we've got 2 objects. And they're going to put in work there. Volcano and Pex both making them bring them frags and open up the A bomb site.
Almost fires as fast as a CZ when he was spamming it there. It was an automatic, but lots of damage done here by TST. They finally get the bomb down, and Daps is the one here to be trying to make things work for Denial, but it's not looking very good as the CZ comes into play and almost making the Tech-9 look better than the CZ in some instances there. I mean, it has pretty darn good accuracy, loads of bullets, and the rate of fire as well as the range that it's usable from all seem to be pretty effective.
Yeah, generally speaking, the CZ here especially was quite useful in that round. It can be more useful for the CTs, but TSC used it in such a fashion where they went for rotating players to eliminate them, so it's bad for them. Indeed, they're going to be on the full eco this time, just rushing with P2000. And the bomb is not too far away from where Nitro is at the moment, just around the corner. So we may find ourselves in an interesting predicament where it's the CT's in control of T-Spawn and the bomb here.
Making their way around, but it's going to be heads popped here for TST. They find player upon player. There's two left, Daps and Naf. Just Naf now, and he is going to find himself going down to the Famas of Volcano. And the buy is not going to come in just yet for Denial. They can actually get some CZs if they all want. They can actually all see a CZ up if they wanted to, but not much more is able to be afforded for them. If they decide not to CZ up, that actually gives them a little bit of extra buffer of money, so that if they do lose the round, that they can still not have to double eco.
Indeed, and again, CST, like we saw in the previous map, slowly getting back into this game here. It's going to be Daps with the only Famas for his team, going to pick up another grenade, and such aggression here from the CT's Nitro chasing all the way through A main. Look how far back the TST players are. This is crazy. Suddenly getting a kill, seeing the bomb as well, which is important. We're seeing the aggressive moving here from his teammate, Shazam, on the B-bomb site. Now they've seen the bomb, he can push forward, expecting nobody to be there. But in fact, he'll have to be careful because there is an angle to the back. She's completely missed.
Shazam not really capitalizing there. Could have been a frag, actually. But Fugly is the one that's gotten the sole two kills of his team. The opening round looked really good, actually, for them. But I feel like maybe they got a little bit too aggressive, taking their luck for granted there. They could have definitely come out with more damage, but regardless, Fugly is going to make his way forwards. Oh, he does spot a Dren, actually, but he won't get the frag, as the Dren is going to take down Fugly. So, five rounds separating these two teams. It's Denial's only advantage, and certainly they can drive it home from this point if they're able to get a good start to this round, so they're buying rounds, Shazam picking up the AWP.
Let's see what Shazam can do with this. His opponent will be unknown, as there is no AWP on the CT side for this particular round, at least for the time being. Volcano's got shot down to 71 HP, not sure where that came from. We've got the nades coming in towards the sniper division, although Shazam has gone back somewhat.
Smoke's all over the place, finally all dissipating. That's not good for the environment. As we have TST maintaining position right now, seeing if they can spot a reaction and give them the info they need. If they were to hit B right now, there's actually two players on the site itself, and that would certainly make it quite difficult. But at the same time, Denial have a nice setup with one going forklift and one at the back boxes, the quad boxes, on A as well. So there's not really a clear, obvious option between the two sites at the moment. Of course, it depends on the style of play you like to go for and the kind of nades, pre-nades that you have to play with as well. You can effectively remove the go on headshot with grenades. And then the B site can be really easy to take in this setup. And it does seem like they are setting up for the B play. Looks like it's going to be the test now for Fugly. See if he can actually succeed here. He comes now from up top. He's able to make one frag as well as Fugly. They're getting cut down before they can get through the entrance even. Two players left now in the vents. Adren and Anger trying to survive, hang on for dear life. Nitro gonna be able to behead Anger and Adren as well. So things going well now for Denial. It's a 13-7 scoreline, but the money is still looking really good for TST.
The Adren caught in no man's land. They're trying to skate back towards T-Spawn, but got cut down like cheese to a grater. Now he is going to be able to afford the AWP. Let's see if he goes up against Shazam, because these early picks, if possible, are doing a lot of things for both teams. Anger going to get stopped from pushing mid, and Adrenaline, there he is, getting Adren, taking out Nitro here. So that's going to be an important frag. We have one person holding either side, two people mid at the moment. We've got the rotations coming in from the CT. Where will they go?
Question. I'm gonna spot A. Oh wow, what a reaction from Shazam. Oh, they lose Volcano pretty much for nothing. Nitro has already gone down, so that will equalize things up. But as far as options goes, it's like They're building towards that B play again. It should go much better than last time. Fogarty is in position on the site, but he's this time pretty much alone. So all that incendiary is going to help massively. Anger's kind of trapped now. Can't actually get out. And I think they know that he's there. They're trying to spam him down, but they're not actually connecting it just yet. Anger going to pop out now onto the assault for the site. Easily deals with Fogarty. Going the way so far of TST as Pex picks one up as well. Naf. Oh, did he actually catch? I think he got the bomb in there, but the bomb did fly onto Anger, who is going to get the bomb down. Two players left on the site. 2-on-2, Shazam coming from the top with the AWP. This is going to be very interesting now as Anger does wait patiently on the bomb site itself with his teammate Pex. As Pex is at the back and Anger's going to get taken down. Getting wallbanged a bit, they know where he is. Does manage to take down Naf. It's all on Shazam right now. He can secure the 14th round here for his team. Just playing around the boxes. He's going to get the frag, pick up the AWP to boot. And that's going to be the round there for TST. But a close one it was. And that's going to force a lot of rebuys.
Indeed. Might be another eco here for Denial. Or they are going to go for the buy, in fact. So they want to close this out as soon as possible. They don't want TST to get another round to close that gap here. So they are going to go all in for the time being. Let's see if they can get any early picks here, any early advantages.
And see now if they're able to find something with this passive play. Do you have, so far, a really nice position with a potential delayed mid-take, but Daps and Vents could cause a bit of turmoil for this mid-attempt. If they don't have correct grenades, and if he pops out of the bad timing, that's all it takes for him to do massive damage from the Vents position. But there is the grenade into the Vents. That's going to find Daps' position. So he does actually evacuate the vent room itself. And he is going to find himself with Shazam now by the sandbags. Able to fall back a bit further and reposition. As TST have yet to really make much of a move, but we check the overview now. We can really see that they're out to spin out of middle. It is Factory Ape looking for that pick towards Vents. There's no one there yet. We saw that already that position was left alone by Denial. As the frags are coming back in favor of Denial now. Locking down middle. Volcano with a great catch there onto Naf as it is squared up. Two players on the B side itself. It looks like TST are going to change up the pace, the movement, the angle onto that A site. There is the player Nitro in position. Gets a quick double frag. It's just one. It's Pex. Does take down Nitro finally. But the bomb will go down in the effort. As he moves close onto his position. Pop flashing himself to try to get himself out of this awkward spot. There's the next pop flash. Can he actually stay put though? That's when they come around the angle. Does take the headshot onto Pex. And he will get the defuse. That's 14 rounds for Denial now. And just a measly 8 for TST. But they were in this position. I think this exact same position on the first map. And then TST were able to bring it back to a 16-14 loss. But still, you know, they came back a lot of rounds in a row.
Indeed. Money looking tight here for TST. At the moment, we're going to have the force buy from them. They don't want Denial to get that magical 15. They are 6 round behind at the moment, and the headshot counter is flying off the charts there. Almost 60 headshots in this round, in this match, sorry. They are going to throw that smoke down, which is going to smoke mid, allow them to emerge through mid, undetected, should they wish to. But in fact, they're going to go straight for a B, it seems. 4 people hovering around the B side. They are rotating back towards mid now, and they're going to get a pick on that flying mid.
Nitro flashed in. They're going to spot Anger behind the white box. In he goes, though, for the re-peek. Does get taken down. Nitro has to get out of there. Running out of ammunition. As we do have in control of middle. And Shazam going to smoke off a main. Smoke down onto short as well. This is something that RDLC do as well. Moving through. Oh, that's a nice flick, but it only catches the legs. And they are all so badly wounded. Daps is just going to town there with the AK. And Volcano and Pex. Below 30 health each, and a quick finish from both of the players. We're onto the 50th round match point for Denial, and this might even be a bit of a battle of endurance for these players, considering how long it's taken to play these matches out as well.
Indeed, and I think the other match from today has possibly finished by now, so hopefully...
5-hour best of 3, yeah.
Indeed, hopefully we can find out what the score of that one was. It was 1-1 last time we checked, so if somebody's won, somebody's won. Well, apparently we've got some brackets to show you after the game, so we'll get back to that. But we do have the fourth spy coming out here for TST. The last chance saloon here. It's their last and maybe not their best effort, but it's the best they could do in terms of weaponry. They need to get these close quarters battles here. They've got Tech 9s, they've got CZs. What can they do there? They've got three around A at the moment, and the way CT's opposition would be a retake here. We do have a Nitro though on the side. He's been fragging great for his team.
Oh my god. Okay, I'm going to start using the Tech 9. And it looks like two frags found into the A site. So 4-on-3, and they are low with a few players, but if these Tech 9s keep putting in work like that, then it's going to be certainly difficult to find themselves back onto the bomb site. There is the armor helmet on these players as well, so Anger coming in the back could prove quite troublesome if they don't move quickly. CZ of Edren going to pick up the kill onto Fugly, as looks like another round for TST in denial. Oh dear, the Tech 9. Honestly, that was the Tech 9. The peeking to the player on the outer catwalk, just the fact that that works so effectively is actually quite scary.
Indeed, and that Tech 9 is a very specific weapon choice. And see, they know something about it if they're using it. And it is going to be denial on the eco now. TST looking to make it 10 rounds instead of 9. So TST slowly catching up. Denial going to have to be careful about this one. They are going to seek A main and a bunch pushing through door as well. So this could be a fast round here for CZ.
It looks like it. Shazam always in between a rock and a hard place. And an orb bullet into the brain. Not very fun times for him, as Naf is going to find the M4. The bomb will go down, and let's have a look and see what Naf is able to accomplish there. Just hiding behind the smoke, and see if he can find a frag. They know that he's in the vicinity. Let's go down, and that's actually a very, very scared adrenaline trying to reposition with the AWP. As Naf gets his ass out of there. Adrenaline ready to go for the re-peek, I think. As he's on the angle, not sure where Naf is going from, but he's galloping around, letting them know exactly where he is. And 15 to 10, denial, in with the buy.
They're going for the fours. So Fugly's bought an AWP and thrown it over to Shazam. Does manage to still buy himself some Kevlar, which is important. We do have all AKs and AWP for the terrorist side, so the lack of helmet won't matter. That said, Daps, Naf, Fly, and Nitro still all buying helmets. That is a clean, it's a clean smoke on AMA, but it wasn't actually that clean. There is a huge gap to the right hand side. The door will be closed as Denial failed to push long on that occasion. Bomb's down in a passive position. We may have a boost here on Angel. I'm not really sure at the moment. Sorry, Anger. Okay, he's just behind the boost spot or something.
Adrenaline
gets shot through the door, down to 11 HP, and he's going to make it out there and go all the way around to mid. Nafly, in the meantime, takes down Volcano in the same location.
So then you got not much to do at the moment. Adrenaline on 11 health. He's going to get put out of his misery by Shazam. Connect the AWP bullet there. And so they've been trying to work onto some picks, but it's not quite really been happening for them.
Running out of time, and they are really spread out at the moment. Look at the position on the ape. He needs to get back to his team, and they need to push this site as a team. We've got Nitro just going up and down the slide there, getting some paper cuts. Molly's and Joy.
There you go, going to take down a Naf up on the outer catwalk. So far, so good. Still a man down, though, and they need to make up for that rapidly. As the fire does extinguish, it's going to be the plant there for Anger. Bomb down. He punches in those numbers, and we're going to see him going for a peek onto some players, but there's just too many for Denar to do this right here, and it looks like Denar are going to be able to get it. And there you go. They're going to sweep it with two maps, 16-14 on Dust 2 against TST, then the 16-10 on Cash, and they are going to make their way forwards. So very well done by them. As it was a quarter-final match, they'll be moving on to the semi-finals of the John Wick Invitational, which we will be continuing the stream of, basically same time, same place, tomorrow night.
It did indeed. It will be tomorrow. And we will end today's stream just with the trailer once again, if you haven't seen it earlier in the stream. And following that, we will see you guys tomorrow. We have got the brackets.
Oh, yeah, the brackets. We can't forget the brackets.
Before. So let's have a look at the fancy brackets. Doing the robot.
You can call it whatever you like. I have no idea what's going on.
It's never too early for the robot.
All right. Brackets.
Apparently, brackets have got to be in 1 second.
I like me some brackets.
Okay, so we've got some awkward screen time. No? Let's not go crazy as we did earlier. That wouldn't be nice.
I don't think that's possible now. The sheer amount of energy we threw into that was quite surprising. We had some cool stuff happen though earlier. We had lots of awesome games today. It's a bit of a blur at this point because, like I said, I've been in this chair for like 14 hours or something. So.
Yeah, it's been a long day of a lot of things.
Mostly casting.
Indeed.
To be specific.
Indeed.
Excellent. And I'm really looking forward to how this the John Wick Invitational is going to progress. Cadian and Avela will actually be taking over, though, for us as we will be progressing with the Face It LAN.
Yes, indeed. They will be here tomorrow night and the night after that as well, so you can look forward to those guys if you're not familiar with them in the North American scene. Yeah, they're nice, good guys, so hopefully we'll see them soon.
And definitely.
Don't know how long this bracket's going to be after being told it's ready. So
James, they better be good after this.
I know.
I'm expecting the best brackets. Oh, okay, it's pretty good. Pretty good. I'm impressed. All right. So it was one result that's still going on right now. But this is how it is as it stands currently. You can see Denal over the stream team there into the semifinals.
Interesting. Sapphire Kelowna. Sorry to interrupt you, but Sapphire Kelowna SKDC 1-0 up against Elevate.
Yep.
I'm not familiar with that team, but I'm quite curious now.
They've been doing pretty well, and we cast a match with them recently. And we'll have to see if they're able to do that. Elevator have looked pretty good, but I think they're a little bit shaky against the Netco guys recently. I think though, Elevate got a lot of work to do still, but they look very promising at the moment.
Indeed,
definitely
they do.
An up and comer for sure.
Yeah, hopefully we can see more of both teams.
We do have. We do see Savage and Mousepads also making it through to the semifinals on the other side, as Area 51. We saw that the start of that game, and obviously Savage able to clinch that. They managed to win season in the end, and so it's shaping up quite well at the moment. And I'm definitely excited to check it out, and I'm a little bit sad that I won't be able to cast it.
But
I can't cast. I can't cast literally everything. I've been trying, and I'm almost succeeding, but can't do everything.
All right, guys, well, that's going to be it for today. So again, just check out the trailer, and then we will see you tomorrow.